We don't always have the luxury of taking footage with a green screen. Sometimes you may have a clip that is perfect for your project and you want to change the background or even just color adjust the background separate from the foreground, and you don't have a green screen to be able to do that. Well, you can take found footage and edit it from the background in After Effects. One way to do that is to use the Roto Brush. So notice that the Roto Brush does not work on a composition. It works on the footage level. So right now I'm viewing in a composition window the composition. What I need to do is have the footage appear in this window. So to do that, double click on the footage. You know that you are seeing the footage because it will say layer rather than composition. You'll also see these masking options down here, similar to the selected mask tools of Photoshop, and a timeline. So to use the Roto Brush, we select it. One thing to note that the Roto Brush can be changed in size from big to small by holding the command or the control key and dragging up to make it larger and down to make it smaller. When you draw with the Roto Brush on your main content, you don't want to go around the outside edges. You want to draw through the piece, through the middle, like a skeleton. So I'm going to do that. So now that this is selected, before I go around to the edges, I want to tell the Roto Brush what is the outside of the frame. So to do that, I want to hold the Option or Alt key. That changes the Roto Brush to subtract. You see the red there. So now I'll drag around the outside, tell the Roto Brush that this is the outside. This is the background. Now we can go in and correct more of the actual figure. So we want to be as accurate as we can on this base frame. So I'll zoom in. Remember that I can change the size of the Roto Brush by holding the Command or Control key. Hold Option or Alt to subtract, and we can make a nice selection. If you make a mistake like that, you always want to Command Z or Control Z to undo. You don't want to give the Roto Brush any false information. So go around, make sure everything is as accurate as it possibly can be. This will be the reference frame, so we want this to be very accurate. We can reduce the chatter a little bit. This will smooth out the Roto Brush, so we probably want to do that. If you look down here, we have this area that has this hair. What we want to do is change from the Roto Brush to the Refine Edge tool. We can draw right over the hair there, and this will do a selective mask, okay? And we'll really refine that edge. If you notice here, we have some issues. So we can change the view. We can switch to the pink outline. We can go to mask. But if you look in the pink outline, you can clearly see that it's selecting too much. So if we go back to the Roto Brush tool and hold Option, and just drag out somewhere over here, that will remind the Roto Brush of what actually is the figure and what isn't. Now we have a much more accurate key, okay, and we can correct this as we go along. Once we have this base frame, notice here we have what's called a span. We have a certain number of frames that it goes out. In this case, it's going out 20 frames. We can increase that span so it starts to calculate the entire length of this clip. This is a short 3-second clip, so we don't have to worry too much. You could always set new base frames, but we're going to use one base frame throughout all of this. Now we want to move forward frame by frame. Press Command right arrow to move forward. Now we want to look around to see if there are any mistakes that changed. And then we say, this is fine. We go forward one more frame. And here you can see that I want to fix just a little bit. So I will go ahead and Command drag down. An Option, and we want to make sure that we fix everything on the first frame we see an issue, because the Roto Brush propagates forward, not backward. For example, I want to fix that right there. If it's not working, you can always go in with the Refine Edge tool, hold Option, and now it will subtract the Refine Edge out of that section to be more accurate. And we go Command forward. You can quickly switch between the Refine Edge tool and the Roto Brush tool by pressing Option or Alt W. Keyboard shortcuts are always going to be your friend. Now we want to keep looking for any time there's a mistake. So right here, I want to fix that before it gets out of whack. So we keep pressing one frame at a time forward, and we see how the Roto Brush is doing. If we see any mistakes, then we go ahead and fix them. But as you can see, it's pretty intelligent and will hold based on what you've instructed it to do. Here we want to make sure that we grab that part of the finger, and then we can zoom in here and subtract that out. Keep going forward. Here is a difficult frame. First, we can easily fix this section down here. Up here, we have so much motion blur. What we want to do is get the Refine Edge tool. Just take a nice big stroke around the outside. It'll take that motion blur and do a pretty good job of only selecting. If we go back to the X-ray, so that's all really the hand moving very quickly. Now we can change the size of this and we can say, you know, really in the middle here now, we don't want you to use the Refine Edge. And here we can say that is part of the figure. So that's pretty good. And then we can just say option over here. This is not. If it doesn't remove, you can always use the Refine Edge tool on Subtract to just get rid of those sections. There, that gets a lot cleaner. So you still sometimes have to tell it what to do. We'll move forward. And now we actually want to say no more Refined Edge up here because it's basically already done. So we're going to go ahead and make this all not be Refined Edge anymore. So now it makes a nice selection without that. Now we continue to go around the hand. As you can see, it does a pretty good job of tracking along as we go. We're just looking for any time the mask doesn't do its job. So right here in between the fingers, we can tell that this is going to be a problem area. So we can go ahead and fix that now. And you don't have to be perfect because remember, this will be moving. So there will be some motion blur that you'll notice as it goes along. And then we just quickly fix some of these sections. Want to make sure that we get all of the thumb right there. And then check all the other sections. Still looking pretty good. We can smooth this out just a little bit. All right, so as we're going along, we're doing great. We've already gone through a whole second of footage so far. As you can see, there's still some work to do, but this is a lot easier than having to perfectly keyframe out a mask. Well, now we're getting great results as we go along. So now we want to pay attention to what's happening here. Here, once again, we'll use the Refine Edge tool for the motion blur. And once we do that, we'll move forward a frame. And some of this we'll be able to remove. And then once again, we can now subtract this Refine Edge from the composition. So now it goes back to normal and can find the edge on its own. Right here by the finger, we can fix that very quickly. And then we just keep propagating forward, making sure that we fix any mistakes as we see them. Now, once we have everything the way we want it to be, then we have to click freeze. So then that will freeze all the Roto Brush frames that we've drawn. That way we don't mess them up while we're editing different things. We can always unfreeze it to make changes, but that will just take more time in the rendering and the setting up of our frames. As you can see now, the Roto Brush is going through each of those frames that we selected, and it's propagating the information forward, and we'll make a nice key. We can go ahead and close the layer. Brings us back to the composition. As you can see now, if I go to any frame, I now have the hand keyed out. I can duplicate this layer, and on the one behind, I can go to the effects and controls, and I can just turn off the Roto Brush. Now, if you look, I can change the opacity of the background however I wish. I can even bring in something in between. So then we could have text that animates. We could have it begin at the very beginning, keyframe the position, and then go to the end of the clip. And then we could have I Love the Roto Brush move just across there. I have a galaxy right here. I could bring this down to the bottom. And then at the beginning of finger snap, this is the one in the background, I can press T for opacity, set a keyframe here, set the opacity at 100%, and I can toggle this to a hold keyframe. A hold keyframe will hold that value. Then I can go forward, and as soon as the fingers snap, so right there, right on that motion blur snap, then I can put the opacity down to 0, and it'll snap right to the galaxy, and then we can be in galaxy land for a little bit. And then we're just about to snap again. And then right on that snap, I can go ahead and put the opacity right back up to 100%. And then we love the Roto Brush. Of course, we can go into the settings of our top layer, and we can change lots of different things in the effects control. We can feather out and refine the edge mat. We can smooth it just a little bit, add some feather. We can shift the edge in or out depending on what we need to do. And we can decontaminate the colors if there's a bright light in your scene. So this is just a basic introduction to the Roto Brush. Hopefully you're able to use it for certain footage that there's no way to take in front of a green screen, be it someone that you are not in contact with, or any footage that you just have in a pinch. This is a great way to be able to do different effects and separate your footage from the background with the Roto Brush tool in After Effects. If you like this content, please click subscribe for more videos. The sample video used in this exercise is available for download. The link is in the description. You can use it to test out the Roto Brush yourself.